How do you do?
We're about to unfold the story of
the son of Frankenstein.
This one is probably just as bad as his father.
Good morning, son.
I just bought a Dracula figure, so with Lugosi.
You just bought a Dracula?
Lugosi figure, yeah, so.
That $499 version from Monsters in Motion?
No, it's really cool, but yeah, it's a little... A little spendy? A little spendy for...
Well, what are you even talking about? Is it one of these?
You've got that Werewolf of London? The little sideshow?
Yeah.
Yeah,
I have that somewhere.
It's that one.
Okay.
And it was only available briefly because Lugosi's estate make it really, really difficult for merchandise to have his likeness.
You know who would thank the Lugosi estate? The Karloff family and the Cheney family. What you've got is a litigious, an actual lawyer.
He's actually
of some
a lawyer.
Repute.
But, Bela and Lugosi so is Jr. apparently the granddaughter.
Okay.
Who's now taken over.
Yeah, because Bela
Jr.
has
got... foot and a half, foot and three quarters in the grave,
yeah,
I think.
There you go. Nice.
See?
Nice callback to...
to a conversation we had
conversation
before.
We had before we were recording. But I think that's... I've read even somewhere that the Karloff family has benefited from...
Oh, absolutely. As has...
the work of the Lugosi family.
Has any celebrity's estate, yes.
Mm-hmm. True, yeah. There's establishing
yeah, so what happened was in the early...
My story. Family, my estate will thank them.
Yes,
when,
they will.
When, my
when
likeness.
Your likeness gets... Yeah. So for those who don't know, and to drag this out even further for Felicity.
Even better for
and
those who don't care.
Jeff off. Yeah. In the early 70s, Bela Jr. was a practicing lawyer, and he became aware that Universal was making a ton of money off of his father's likeness on masks, toys, model kits, things like that. And he put the kibosh on that pretty quick by suing them. And it went round and round and round for almost a decade, I believe.
Okay.
And the upshoot is that now estates of... because Universal's thing was, well, you know, he's a public figure.
Okay.
We can do whatever the fuck we want with him.
Yeah, we own the movie Dracula.
Yeah. And so now it's... why you see on toys where it'll say, you know, the estate of Lon Chaney or the Karloff Associates or whatever, it's because of what he did to ensure that these families and estates would get remuneration for the likeness of their dead relative.
And I think a lot of times you see the headline of a story will make someone look like they're being greedy. Like, Lugosi,
no.
Probably at some point, Lugosi estate...
Would you stop that, please?
The Lugosi estate wins big, millions of dollars or whatever, but what it really does is establish a precedent for everybody.
Yeah, no, it's not greed. It was just simply...
Well, it could be greed, but it still establishes a precedent for everybody else.
No, I don't believe it was. I think it was a legitimate gripe.
It's like if Shatner wasn't getting paid for all those Halloween movies. I wonder, you know?
Yeah.
You think he's got a case for it.
Oh, now you planted a seed in his mind. If he's listening...
Shatner's a big fan.
He's a big... Yeah, he's a Patreon, isn't he?
He's a Patreon.
We can't say it when we thank them because it's...
Yeah, right. Yeah. He, for those that don't know, everyone knows. I'm not going to...
Hey, why even bother? Because everybody knows.
Everybody knows.
But, like, when they do a toy now of Dracula, 9 times out of 10, it'll be a generic face.
Mm-hmm.
It won't be Lugosi, and a lot of people complain about that.
Mm-hmm.
But it's just because they are far more difficult to work with than
the Carlos,
the
Villarias.
The Chaneys. Yeah, Villarias. They'll put his face on anything.
I mean, like, so when you buy a Dracula figure and he's grinning like a fucking dope... That's why.
It's Carlos.
It's Carlos. It's supposed to be Carlos. That's the Carlos Dracula.